Currently in the state of Illinois, we're in the middle of severe weather season. This is also what people might call tornado season, with this being part of Tornado Alley. On this blog, I've covered some of the radio systems that I use in this area to listen to things like ham radio, emergency services, the airband, and so on. And rather than get blindsided by these violent thunderstorms when they appear in our area, I actually have a few of them configured to listen in on radio services that might be useful for detecting these storms and trying to figure out just how severe the storms are going to be when they reach this area. If you're interested in using radio systems like this for yourself, just be sure to check the laws in your area. Everything that you see here is designed to only receive radio signals, but depending on your location, your country, or your state or province, there might be restrictions on what you can receive and what you can record. Some locations in some countries might require that you have some type of a license in order to listen in. Others might ban these frequencies altogether. Basically, my strategy is when I know these storms are approaching due to checking the forecast in advance, I'll normally tune the radio into one of three frequencies, sometimes all three at once. Here in the United States, the easiest way to do that is to tune in to the National Weather Service. Across the entire country, there are radio transmitters that are fixed, and they operate 24 hours a day. You can tune into them at any time, and they constantly transmit weather reports.
Station WXJ75 in Springfield.
The second radio service that I use, which is probably the more significant of the three, is Skywarn Radio. The way this works, at least here in central Illinois, is we have a number of ham radio repeaters. This one that you see here is tuned into 444.4 MHz, and this is part of the 70 centimeter band. This is what storm spotters use to communicate to both each other and the National Weather Service. One of the limitations that you have with pretty much any type of radar is that they can't see any type of event that's happening very close to the surface, and that's really where the storm spotters come into play. Very timely weather reports, reporting high winds, reporting flooding, reporting funnel clouds, and because this is part of the UHF band or the ultra high frequency band, the antenna that you use to receive it isn't very large, so it's definitely something that you can use right on top of your own workbench, and it doesn't take up very much space. This receiver here is based on a Raspberry Pi 3B Plus, and the radio receiver is a rtl-sdr, which is short for Realtek Software Defined Radio. The software you see running is called GQRX. It's very useful for visualizing the transmission that you're receiving, and it's been working so well that you can see I've been building up a second unit just like it. I think this one's going to use probably a slightly newer version of this Linux distribution. This exact version of the RTL-SDR dongle is what you might call an accurized version. So it has a temperature-controlled oscillator inside that sort of helps reduce the drift and some of the inconsistency that you have with the really cheap, extremely low-cost dongles. Normally this chipset won't receive below about 24 to 30 megahertz, that's sort of its lower end, but you can receive below those frequencies if you use direct sampling mode. You can also use external hardware to reach those lower frequencies, like an up converter. In this case here, I'm not using an up converter because most of what I'm interested in is above 140 megahertz. Finally, the third service that I use, which is really more of a network, uses the APCO P25 format, which is a digital radio format. It's trunked radio, so there's a control station, and in order to follow each conversation, you wouldn't need to use additional software just to keep track of those trunked conversations. Anytime the police or a fire department or a medical dispatch goes out, this is the range of frequencies that they're going to use. This radio traffic is concentrated near 852 megahertz. This setup here that I have on screen is using a scanner. The scanner does the job, but it's not quite as good as using specialized trunking software, because if you really want to follow each individual conversation, you do need to distinguish one talk group from another. Secondly, like I mentioned, this is a digital format, and so using software like GQRX or SDR Sharp by themselves probably won't do it unless you have some type of a decoder plugin. In my case, since I'm using SDR Sharp with Windows in this setup, I have SDR Sharp piping its audio, its digital audio, to a software utility called an audio pipe. That audio pipe sends that raw audio to another application called DSD Plus, and DSD Plus is the application that converts the raw digital format to plain audio. Of course, with anything involving technology, there's always room for improvement, but the nice thing about the Raspberry Pi is that it is fairly easy to integrate outside hardware, and because it's on a Linux platform, there's a lot of potential for customization. So that's it for now. You'll probably see these platforms in the future as I upgrade things and try out new ideas for the receivers. If you found this useful, I do have a setup guide. As always, be sure to like, share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. If you find this topic generally useful, be sure to check out our Patreon page where we have a monthly poll and lessons learned on technical builds like this one. And as always, have a great day.